afternoon to all the great souls of this nation. That's teachers. Now, before I start off this presentation, it's not a presentation. I've already done my presentation in the Higher Education Summit. And I just wanted to, you know, talk for like quick 5 minutes only. Teachers build future leaders of India. Teachers build future leaders of India. That was being said by my guru and mentor, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So I believe one of the bestest passion, one of the bestest profession in India is teaching. Because there is a very old saying, Mata, Pita, Guru and Devam. So God comes only after a teacher. So teachers play a very crucial role in today's society. And with so much up for you, all you people, I quickly wanted to introduce Let Skills Learning. Now, Let Skills Learning is an authorized Indian partner for Learning A to Z. I'm sure most of the schools here and most of the teachers here are aware of Learning A to Z and Learning A to Z's products. So from K-12, from pre-K to K-12, we have products for science, for kindergarten, as well as for advanced levels of IB medium and CBSC medium or whatever mediums you call it as. I'm not a teacher, I'm an educator. I've been doing this for the last 10 years. Now, a great panel and great discussions was happening. What I really wanted to understand is when you teach something in a classroom, in a class of 40 students or 50 students are there, whatever you're teaching, is all the students can understand at one go? If the answer is yes, then you are a great teacher. Because what happens in a typical classroom environment is, if a teacher is teaching something, or if there is any kind of delivery which is happening in a classroom, in a class length of 40 or so, only 10% of the top elites of the pyramid students can understand what the teacher is going through, or what the teacher is teaching or implementing. Well, ma'am said about teacher training, which is important for schools, and also the need of the hour is teacher trainings and all. But cities like Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Mumbai, we have the elite schools and elite students where parents are already either a software engineer or an IT person who has got the exposure. But when you talk about the rural India, that's what the primary concentration is all about here today. Because for me, as an educator, what I see is, if this nation, if this country has to be built, especially in the field of education, it can happen only from the rural section as well as from the rural part of India. So there are more school owners who is not even educated in the rural sector. They run schools. A lot of people, who doesn't even know ABCD of NCERT and NCF are the school owners with having like 2,000 students and 3,000 students in their classes. Now, what's going to happen for them? It's like a big question mark. Yes, schools are always worried about TRPs and always worried about what their performance is. But end of the day, how many schools can give a guarantee that the child is going to be successful in life? That's a big question mark. Now, what I have understood, why am I talking all these things? What I have understood is, we're talking about preschool learning and early learning and all these things. Now, every parent's primary, first expectation from the school is, my son or daughter should speak excellent English. This is the first requirement of any parent. Let it be an auto driver, or let it be a coolie, or let it be a farmer, or let it be a IT person or a software person. When I have to listen to my daughter or to my son speaking first English, that's the joy what the parents are going to get. Now, what's happening inside a classroom is, I'm sure teachers will agree to this or may not agree also, but English is being taught as a subject in the classrooms today, where it is supposed to be taught as a language. And most of the students, even today, class 7 CBSE students, if you have to give them a simple extempore topics and ask them to come on a stage and talk, they have this fear of speaking in front of the public. Now I'm talking about CBSE schools in tier 1 and tier 2. Now you considering tier 3 and tier 4, teachers are really great. They do 8 hours of teaching and they also continue their life again with 8 hours in their household, taking care of their husbands and sons and daughters. So when they have to stand up in the class and ever 45 minutes into 8 periods, it's not an easy task. So, but if the right resources are being given to them in a right way of understanding, they can do much better. I'm sure every teacher would have gone through basic LSRW skills and learning in their B.Eds and in their D.Eds and all these things. But this LSRW skills have been implemented for a four-year-old where only writing importance has been given first in India. You know, where there is absolutely no listening comprehension which happens in a classroom. Now, when there is no listening comprehension happening in a classroom, it is very difficult for a child to pick up a language which is called as English, which has been considered as second language in India. Now, why I'm telling all these things is, English is the gateway for success. If a child can pick up basic English, okay, I'm talking about, you know, from class one onwards, from the time the child completes his schooling, if the English speaking skills is good, he or she will be able to take competitive exams much better. I represent from a state called Tamil Nadu, which is always backwards when it comes to writing and taking competitive exams, because students have the fear to take competitive exams. It's only because of one thing. Either they are fear-phobic of speaking bad English, or you know, they don't have the exposure because the teachers have not taught how to speak good English. But this gap is what I have identified in this last 10 years. I worked with top corporates for almost 9 years, from 2003 to 2009. And I left my high-paying job in Tech Mahindra in 2009. I was drawing 2.75 lakh salary a month. But in this last 10 years, all I've been doing is getting inside a classroom, and I have observed a lot of innovative, different ways how a teacher is teaching any kind of concepts to the child. 90% of the teachers, I have asked this question: why did you become a teacher? Why did you join? What's the passion behind being a teacher? You know, I got very disappointing answers. Even in rural, they say, it's a safe job, sir. My husband wanted to become a teacher. My parents wanted me to become a teacher. It's, you know, great souls like this. Yes, passionate people who are there, but not every place you have this passion. So in order to take this passion more, we need something to be delivered. It's just the methodology has to be changed and the implementation process has to be changed. Now, yesterday we had some panels of artificial intelligence and you know, lot of discussions about 21st century, 21st century leadership skills and learning skills and all these things. A computer cannot ask questions. It can only give answers. Okay, I'm not against technology, but it's the human interference again which can, you know, make wonders. And that human interference can and will be only teachers, because it is end of the day, it is not just 40 students for a teacher in a classroom, it is 40 lives after 15 years. So if this nation on a whole, if it has to get progressed and if it has to be successful in 2025 reaching 5 trillion economy, there are so many education companies and there's so many advanced schools who's teaching, you know, all kinds of concepts and all kinds of things. But the primary importance has to be given for teacher trainings and methodology of teaching language in a classroom. That's very important. Science follows later. Technology follows later. The first thing is, how do you teach basic phonics and basic sounds? If the child can identify the sounds, that's more than enough. Any teacher goes inside a classroom and says that I'm going to teach grammar, 70% of the students get scared. Indian students get scared. And almost like 80% of the students will not even understand the difference what the teacher is talking when it comes to grammar. So in order to identify, I mean, after identifying all these things, that's when Learning A to Z comes into India. I'm sure Learning A to Z products are very great and ranked number 4 globally, which is operating in more than 180 countries worldwide. And we are the authorized Indian partners for Learning A to Z. And the product comes with the right resources for the teachers at the right time. So I kind of like wanted to simplify the lesson plans and the worksheets and discussion cards and all these things. So we have customized it according to the Indian child's needs. So psychologically, if a teacher has been given the right resources and pumped with the right, you know, methodologies, every child in the classroom will be on top of the pyramid. There is nothing called as bottom of pyramid students and mid-level students and, you know, top-level students. Yes, top-level students to hoega, but today's world, every school is chasing only marks. I'm so sorry to say, but I mean, every other institution wants to be number one. If everyone wants to be number one, why is India passing out 8 crore graduates, engineering graduates, and 94% are not fit to be hired? I mean, companies like Infosys, Dell, Wipro, you know, these are the companies which has made statements. Wall Street Journal says, India has got more number of English medium schools We're concentrating on English medium schools a lot today. But if you see the realistic statistics data of 2019 AESR report, 94% of engineering grads are not fit to be hired. A class 7 student is telling, I want to become an engineer after my completing my 12th standard. A class 11 student is telling, I either want to become a doctor. Social entrepreneurship has to be promoted in schools, and that has to come right from the early learning. So this is one thing that we are primarily focusing on, and have started a project called as Project English. That's the name of the project, and it's a very simple motto with a simple vision. I want to make sure that every farmer's son and daughter in India should be able to read, write, and speak excellent English the way world wants, without making any kind of grammatical sentence, errors in when they are delivering. And primarily concentrate more on reading skills, because that's one thing which is lacking in Indian schools today, because no child wants to read for more than 10 minutes in a day if you have to hand over a newspaper or if you have to hand over any kind of books. Simple thing. I mean, if this reading skills can be implemented in a very fun way, education through entertainment, that's what I call it as edutainment, next level of teaching kids. And yes, apart from this, all big personalities are there. I don't have to talk about the same thing. But mera experience main bol dunga, I got bored looking at my teacher for the same teacher for 10 years. You know, again and again and again and again and again, going through the same thing. Every child in the classroom will definitely get bored of looking at the same teacher throughout his career. It's not because of who you are as a character. It's because of the personality. And that personality can be changed when we innovate with more kinds of different methodologies when we teach. That's it. So this is one thing that, you know, I wanted to convey. And more than 3,000 schools we have trained so far. And I have personally trained more than 1,000 teachers, and I'm still not satisfied with the way teacher trainings can be implemented in schools, especially the tier 3 and tier 4. That's where the potential is all about, and that's where the nation is going to grow. So I have started this as a revolution, and I never wanted to become an entrepreneur, by the way. So now I'm very passionate about this, helping teachers to be lifelong successful people. So as I said in the beginning itself, Mata, Pita, Guru and Devam, God is after you people. So if this nation, as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam said, 100 billion youth cannot go wrong. That was in his time. You know, technology was, we just had only one Abdul Kalam for this whole entire, lifetime of whatever we had. If we have to create more of them, it's all in the hands of the teachers. And not, I can just be a small person who can just help and support a teacher. But I am not a teacher. I respect this profession. And yeah, we are talking about curriculums, and we're talking about policies and education policies and all these things. If I was to be the chief minister, and if I was to be a prime minister, and if I had the power, I would definitely, first and foremost thing, what I would be doing is, government school teachers or private school teachers, doesn't matter. Teachers has to be paid more, and teachers has to be given more, because that's when... because that's when you get the best out of, the future of India. As a country, if we are looking forward to build something, compete with America and China, we have the best resources and we have the best talents. Remember, America is producing only 33,000 engineers in a year. But India, Chennai alone, passes out 1,75,000 engineers in a year. But we are still lagging behind. We are still lagging behind. Volkswagen can cheat America and be number one in automobile. Whereas Indian agriculture has gone, no one wants to get into farming. No one wants to get inside and take farming to the next level. Cutting edge technologies are not there in India. We are talking about digital learning, tab learning, 21st century skills, leadership skills, everything fine. Just a small incident. I'm sure everyone remembers this. 2 months before, there was a 2-year-old kid who had fallen inside a sump in a 100-feet sump in a bowl in a remote village. IIT came. IIT came. IIT is one of the biggest pioneering engineering institutes in India. 6 engineering teams came. Larsen & Toubro came. ONGC came. They could not drill down and they could not save the 2-year-old kid out of the sump which had fallen. What are you talking about engineering products and engineering graduates? I mean, everyone wants to become an engineer. Everyone wants to build a nation. This failure led to more things, for me, because I took it as like, if I have to do something, I have to do only one thing I can do. change the methodologies for teachers when they're delivering the concepts. Of course, I cannot invent any new laws or any kind of new things. But if I am not understanding A square plus B square formula, I would rather help the teacher to put it across in a better way. So what kind of way is this project is all about? And please do visit our stall, Lit Skills Learning, and you can get more information about it. And I'm telling you, I'm not against teachers, or I'm not against the institutions or the owners. I'm just worried about the methodologies, what the teacher can deliver inside a classroom, so that when Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam said, teachers build future leaders of India, I'm really worried about the kids who are studying in every other school. It's not just children, it's lives after 15 years or 16 years of, you know, schooling. Thank you so much for the opportunity. And a long way to go. With all the heartfelt respect for teachers, you guys are awesome and you're always great. I'm very proud to be working with this in kind of industry and helping teachers to attain what maximum they need to attain. Thanks a lot. Jai Hind. Thanks.